Okay, hello. Nigel Carlton once again. For the five of you who watched my top 20 songs list, I know I got some great reviews on that. Such reviews as I'm gonna fucking make fun of you. How did I get subscribed to this shit, Jesus? Got some great reviews coming in. It's not my top 11 albums of the year yet. That video will be coming real soon. I made the list today. I got it narrowed down. Today I just want to talk about a few honorable mentions that came out in the year. These are albums that I really enjoy. They're just not necessarily albums that I put on my top 11 list. So let's get started here. All right, what do we got? We got World Unite Lucifer Youth Foundation. Go Tell Fire to the Mountain. That's a mouthful of an album. Woo Life kind of just represents why I got into indie music in the first place, if you want to call it indie rock music. Just like really great melodies, I like the production. These guys also kind of like this punk attitude on stage, and also I remember there was a whole big thing about them refusing to do interviews. I don't know if that turned out, I think that turned out to be a lie, but there's some really good songs on here. Dirt is an amazing song, Concrete Gold. Definitely a band that you guys should check out if you're into, you know, just classic indie rock. Black Lips, Arabian Mountain. This was a really surprising album for me. I really never got into the Black Lips before this album. And if you're a fan of like the Stooges or the Clash, Mark Ronson produced this, and he really brings back that 70s punk sound. If you're into like the classic punk music, definitely an album you guys check out, Black Lips, Arabian Mountain. All right, The Strokes with Angles. I know this album got a lot of mixed reviews when it first came out. I feel like The Strokes were, unfortunately, a band that were kind of doomed because, you know, after Is This It came out, everybody just, you know, what are they going to do next? Lightning only strikes once. You can't, you know, do the same formulaic thing over and over again. So on this album, The Strokes kind of, you know, they take a somewhat different approach on a couple of these songs. They, you know, capture, the arrangement is a lot better. They capture, you know, sounds of like early, it's like 70s rock. It's a really great album. I actually enjoyed it quite a bit, more than I thought I would. Yeah, The Strokes of the Angles, definitely check that one out. This one, for people who know me personally, might come as a surprise, being on the honorable mentions list, not on my top 11 list. This is an album that I really enjoyed. It was, you know, really hyped up. I really enjoyed the singles that he released coming up to this album, but he made a few just choices on this album that I kind of turned me off a little bit. That's okay. Panda Bear, Tomboy. It's the deluxe edition here. Collector's edition my girlfriend bought it for me. It's classic Panda Bear. There's definitely some songs on here I love. Production choices. Oh, with a little Lithion. That's okay. Still a great album, Tomboy. Okay, this one came out early on in the year and I pretty much automatically loved it. Hawk and a Hacksaw. For those who don't know who this is, you probably don't. It's the Jeremy Barnes project. You know Jeremy Barnes from, he's the drummer of Neutral Milk Hotel. And it's basically him and this girl, Heather Trost, I believe, basically making Balkan folk music in 2011. It's really great. Love the time signatures on here are very unique. It's definitely something if you're looking for something a little out there, you're looking to expand a little bit. How can you go wrong with Balkan folk music? A Hawk and a Hacksaw with Servantine. Oh, I love this album cover. 10 Tricks Point Never with Replica. If you watched my top 20 tracks of 2011, you know I like the song Sleep Dealer off this thing. And basically took a bunch of samples from 80s commercials, wherever you found the samples, found sound, and just created an album basically with these droning synths, which is classic. But anyway, this is a really great album. Power of Persuasion is a great song. Replica is a great song. Definitely an album to check out if you're into kind of ambient drone music. This album is really important for a couple different reasons. This is Treyer, Afterlife, an abandoned theme park. This is basically a concept album. The reason why it's important is A, it's free. You can go into his Bandcamp, I'll link that. You can download this album for free. It's over an hour long. It's divided into three parts. Each part is insane. But it's important because I believe that this album kind of represents the direction that I think electronic music should be going. It's super melodic. He mixes in live sound, you know, live trumpets, live, you know, guitar and stuff, and just really creates a unique, he has his own unique sound on this thing. I really like it. Treyer and Afterlife and Abandoned Theme Park. And these last two, they came out this year. They're technically reissues. I didn't even know if I could put those on my technically my top 11 list, but I loved them anyway. Let's talk about Smile by the Beach Boys. Brian Wilson really took a unique approach to production on this thing. It's been years and years in the making, decades in the making, but I think the final lineup that he has of the songs on here is pretty good. And finally, last but not least, Gedalia Tazardes, I don't know if I'm saying that right, Diasporas. He's a French musician. This album came out initially in the 70s. Very unique sound. He's basically taking, you know, chanting and like drone music. And it's really unique that it's kind of an avant-garde album to come out in the 1970s. I heard it in a record store in Minneapolis, and I actually had to ask the guy. I don't like to do that. Because I'm kind of shy about that stuff. Like, I should know. But I asked him, like, you know, what is it? And I bought it. Definitely an album to check out if you're into, you know, unique, just tribal music. I really enjoy it. It's my honorable mentions. Yeah, that's about it. The top 11 list will be, you know, filmed pretty soon. It's probably filmed now by the time I'm filming this, but yeah. I'm a rope man.